Professor Amir Mehdi will start and take my place now because he is the chairman of the day. The chairman of the day, he is the chairman of the conference in this meeting of this day. He will govern the schedule and take care of everything. I by myself will obey his idea for his limiting the time for me, and he will take the responsibility of taking us for the time and sticking for the rules of discussion. The time is, I'd like to tell you something. I feel sorry that we do announcement since about 3 weeks about we are in need for some cases for the Facebook in the LRS, Facebook group. We ask that we have, we can say grant or business for any one of our colleagues, either LRS trainee or previous one or not engaged in LRS program, to present just a case about soft tissue and bone problem. 2 or 3 weeks waiting, and I have about 5 active persons from LRS. I tried usually to capture them so as not to, usually they are start and present. I cover them, waiting for some colleagues other than those 5, but I'm sorry, I have no other those 5. So they present for us 5 cases. We choose 2, one of them of Dr. Fadi Hayawi from LRS version 4, I think you are LRS 4. 3, yeah. And also Dr. Fahad from Iraq, our colleague, and Dr. Muhammad Kondi from Libya, LRS 4. So we still have continuous medical education of LRS from 1, group 1, until LRS 5, and the brilliant ones is still the same and continue with us. They are doing well and also continue with us as a trainers for their colleagues, or teaching assistant, like I would like to say that. Now with Dr. Fahd to present his case, then Dr. Muhammad Kondi. Usually we are concise with them to present the case in a few minutes and take some questions and finish all this, all the problem in 10 minutes. Usually we used to do this in LRS discussions and LRS training in our lectures weekly in the Institute of LRS. So Dr. Fahd, we try to show how we finish the case, presentation and the discussion and get it in just 10 minutes. Okay? Father Dr. Fahd, we will start now.
Assalamu alaikum. First of all, it's a great honor to stand here in front of my professor, my colleague. We have a case to be presented. It's a female patient, 10 years old, road traffic accident 4 months ago. On admission to emergency department, there were bilateral deformed lower limb, thigh and the leg. The x-ray shows bilateral femoral fracture and bilateral tibial fracture. Of course, after resuscitation and stabilization of the general condition, right tibia is fixed by a plate and screw with expiration and repair of the injured or right popliteal artery. The left tibia is fixed by intramedullary nail. Also, the both femur are fixed by flexible intramedullary nail. This is the right tibia, which is our concern in this case. It's fixed by a plate and screw otherwhere. This is for the right tibia. Unfortunately, for on the second post-operative day, the patient developed popliteal vein thrombosis, which need embolectomy. 1 week later on, the skin over the right tibia sloughed, which need debridement and split the skin, split thickness skin graft to cover the raw area. The graft also failed and the plate exposed, so we are obliged to do transpositional facial cutaneous flap was done 2 weeks later to cover the exposed plate. Unfortunately, the plate exposed again, so now we have an exposed plate, bad soft tissue condition, wasting of the muscle, the patient doesn't walk since 3 months. This is the clinical photo of this patient.
You can see the very bad soft tissue condition, exposed the plate. Also, there a pressure sore on the heel and stiff knee joint. This is another photo. So, what can we do for this patient? That's a question.
What about the vascularity?
Vascularity, the right popliteal artery is, as I said, it's the right popliteal artery is repaired. The fixation, the dual fixation of the right tibia. Nowadays, we have a plan to do angiography. Really, we didn't do it later on. Muscle says the vascular
to
you.
Yes.
So the vascularity will direct us.
Why didn't you remove the plate from the why doing
that? Really, it's not my case.
It's the surgeon? Mm-hmm.
Yes, I don't know. Really, it's prepared for us to discuss what to do. See
it
what.
It's better to remove the plate and do the scan and fixation.
Okay.
Even scanning, scan and fixation, why doing that?
Okay.
I think this is good paper. I'm leaving that plate.
I would like to declare something that this case belonged to one of my colleagues in Albania, Albania University, and he emailed it for me, and I was happy that he made it for our guest. It is a chance now to present it to you, Dr. Rodriguez. Please stand up for our colleagues. This is our guest, Dr. Rodriguez, from Chicago, from UCA. He came to share us, and I threw this bomb for him since I think 5 days or a week. This is one of the difficult cases. We are seeking for his solution, actually, and practically in Armenia, inshallah. I think we have some idea. If you have a conclusion for this case, if you'd like to present it, it's okay. If you'd like to keep it for working there in Armenia, it's okay. You'd like to present some idea here or later on in Armenia? This is one of the some cases I made it to.
Yeah, I remember the pictures of this one. My main concern will be at this point in the underlying bone is stable enough that the plate will be removed. Then the angiography, I think, would be it's a very good idea to figure out the popliteal vessel, the valve, posterior tibial also. But clinically, I would have to examine the patient and see if there's a possibility of doing a gastro or a soleus muscle flap. I think at this point, the answer will be doing a muscular flap. Not a fascial cutaneous or subcutaneous skin. There may be there's also contracture, flexor contracture of the knee that needs to be addressed at the same time.
I think there is a flexion contracture and the stiffness of the knee.
So hamstring release. Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you have the last extreme?
Still non-related, and the condition is not stable and not amenable for good results as we see how much the muscle is fibrotic and the soft tissue already in need for support or in need for some solutions or some clues to improve the circulation or improve the soft tissue and the skin and even the subcutaneous tissue, which is very good. I think it's a very difficult case and full of
challenge.
Yes. patient vomited, muscle fibrotic, vascularity not known well, we need for angiography, yes. Also the muscle and the motor power also questionable. We asked them, please also to do AMG and their production velocity, and also to test the muscles, the even the tendons are fibrotic. To solve a condition like this, they need for all these things to have a good result. Dr. Mahmoud Rasas, you have a comment?
Resolve traditional resolve techniques, application of resolve frame with acute shortening in the proximal tibia is very risky. And actually, in my lecture, I will talk about this in details in my lecture, maybe 1 p.m. today. We can resort to bone transport. Bone transport, in brief, is a form of like a flap, transposition of osteomyocutaneous flap, transport distally to proximal, and at the same time will extend the frame to the femur with a hinge and gradually extend the correct reflection contraction to them.
Yes.
This is another approach to the
situation. I think this is logic to follow at least some steps from this. Gradual shorting by doing a distal corticotomy and proximal advancement of the distal part gradually. I think this will keep some of the soft tissue and the muscle redundant for acceptance of this propagation proximally, and this will solve to some extent the necrotic and the bare area of the
I mean, there are several cases like this.
Sure. Thank you. Any more question or comment? Yes. Welcome.
Sorry, I'm not here for the start. This is my case. I go for a straight technique. I go to just excise osteolytic part in the middle, and I go to put and cement with antibiotic. Then I go to cover it with gastrocnemius flap. Okay. Muscular technique will make a membrane. Okay. Then after 2 months, I'll go and cut that membrane and remove the cement, and I go to put an electrostograph regularly. Okay. It will give a very good result. Okay. You have an experience about this. And I think it's more simple than corticotomy and osteotomy and whatever. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Michael.
We've got a chance to ask you about your name and from where, because most of had been delivered their comments.
Our faculty of the LRS, the professional diploma, and we, most of us, know them, but I think you are...
Okay, I'm Muhammad Al-Jamil, lecturer of Osmanic Carriers.
Welcome here, Muhammad. Your idea and your technique is very nice and welcome, but I think there is some problems in using this technique in this case. Anyone?
I think it's a vascular problem rather than an infection problem.
My idea is more than this. The vascular technique, a need for
there is an infection.
Coverage. And the skin is a question. So if you put some sort of bone graft, you even if you make it a small column, you can use it as some sort like one finger in the thickness to use the
muscle and soft tissue to cover this small column, because the column of the tibia is, and after doing the musculoskeletal, you will have a small diameter of bone. This is my idea about using this in the tibia, which is in need for.
I put the same of all diameter of the tibia.
Okay, coverage, the cover?
Coverage is by gastrocnemius flap.
Gastrocnemius flap, yeah. in nice, very nice. This will reserve us for, what is the condition of the gastrocnemius? Is it fibrotic? Is it working? Is it have its blood supply? This is questionable for this also. Okay, agree? That we are in need for arteriographic stuff.
Okay.
The condition is all acute, accepted, but some need, some don't. Yeah. Dr. Hazel,
I want to ask about the range of movement.
Actually, as I said,
I think there is no range. And with this collection, soft tissues,
yes.
And fibrotic.
Yes.
Collection deformity to such degree and no expected movement, I think it's more wise sometimes to be, and this is the experience of life, that make sure for the skin and make amputation. Thank you.
Okay, the problem of amputation, I just feel the question from Minya, from my colleague there, that the problem is that she's about 10 years old first, and the trials not end yet. They ask for more options for them. Yes, it is first, in this case, you can say amputation and relief yourself, yes. I have more comments, but we succeed now. Just Dr. Mahmoud Rizazi, excuse me, and also Dr. My colleague, Dr. Kamil Shok, welcome here, to thank Dr. Fahd and say that we succeed to present a case in some minutes, have about 6 or 7 ideas in 10 minutes. Okay, thank you, Dr. Fahd.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.